fucking months, baby. You know I love you. God bless. Thank you, bro. I do appreciate it. You know, fuck him up tomorrow. I believe in you, man. All right. Llama Beans, Mata, Legendary Leia, Steam Spark, Direct to Scar against Mr. T Nasty, Daquan, The Mistborn, Nuclear Eli, and Armstead. This is actually a pretty good match. Hopefully, people don't fuck it up. Is this a sub game? No. It's like a sub viewer game, but I can't believe you guys fucked up three times in a row. You guys are wild. Can I roast you? No. By the way, for all new subscribers, make sure you sync up to my sub Discord. Wait, I forgot to start my second light this whole time. Damn. I look good. The guy who left? I don't even see who left. I mean, whoever left, left. And there's nothing I could do. It's just... Yeah, Serenos, Thothman, Medusa, Sylvanas. Okay. Standard shit. Why does the team keep switching sides? I don't know. High res? Let me tweet about that, huh? Dear... Whoever designed this new spectator. Why do the teams switch sides every pick? Do you just hate me? Do you not want me? Do you want my brain to scramble? Scramble. Yeah, okay. Like, what the fuck? No, Anka, I don't understand why that's a thing. It actually doesn't make any sense. My ADC is trash, but was still able to first blood zap my ADC. I mean, that's Zapman. Zapman loves dying. By the way, Giannis first pick for the red team. Thana, Kabrakan. How did Thana and Kabrakan make it through? What the fuck? You guys don't know how to ban. Actually, the blue team don't know how to prioritize. That's the thing. Osiris. Osiris versus Kabrakan. I'm pretty sure Osiris wins that early. Kabrakan just kind of deals. But we'll see. Hunt snacks. I respect it. I want to see what they do with this Giannis pick. Alright, Susano. I respect it. Alright, blue team, what are you picking? The Mistborn actually did decent last game. It's just the Knight kind of transitioned from early game dominance to nothing. Like, he was tanky, but as you saw through the damage charts, the Knight did, like, the least damage. Like, he just wasn't doing anything. So, we'll see. Rama, pretty safe pick. I don't know what the blue team's goal here is, but so far they have a pretty nasty lineup. As far as the red team have a decent team comp as well. It just depends on how this Giannis plays that out. In the mid lane, at least. Also depends on the mid lane matchup. The switching every time is stiff, I agree. I don't understand what Hires was thinking. Because I don't know what the fuck Hyros was thinking with that, like, as if that was a good idea. Like, they can't ever just make anything simple or right. They have to, like, scramble my shit. I'm banned. That shit's small. Yo, Vash's Zeus did really good. I respect the Poseidon ban, by the way. Poseidon with that team comp is like super cancer. Like, fuck that, dude. The Apollo ban, I guess, to deal with split pushing. As we know, my viewers and subs don't know how to deal with split pushing. They have no clue. They're just fucking stupid. I don't know why they don't know. You guys just lose the split pushing, I feel like. Nuclear Eli, what are you picking, brother? Mr. T Nasty actually did pretty good with Rama last time, so I mean not Rama, but ADC, so let's see if he goes Rama. They might switch it up. And Armstead's support was really good. Just sucks he was on a shitty team. Nuclear Eli picking Nox. I don't know. Nox is very hit or miss. It really depends on the person playing Nox. Yo, huge shout out to Karn Gossel. I appreciate the subscription. Welcome to the church, my man. God bless. Yeah, by the way, tomorrow will be only sub games. Only sub games. So, if you're a subscriber in the chat and want to play, well, tomorrow's the day. I'll make it only subs only. Today was kind of like a test run to see how we're going to see how we're going to do it. And I have a good idea now. And I'll give out the gems after stream. So, after stream, everyone that well, only Miniflab giving you 400 gemaroonies. And if you don't like it, well, tough cookies, brother. Tough cookies. Daquan's gonna fuck that team. I guess so, man. Daquan's always been, like, super consistent. Even, like, on the losing team, Daquan just generally is good at solo. And he's picking, like, his best soul laner, which is Wukong. He could carry. Armstead's going Kabrak in support, which I agree with in this matchup. Director Scar is going Ares, so GG right there. I don't think Director Scar... Yeah, Director Scar's fucked. He's fucked. Director Scar is going to feed his shit out. Team comp-wise? Who has the better team comp? Blue team for sure. Blue team, in my opinion, has the better team comp. Mr. T Nasty. Yeah, blue team should win this. I can't see why not. They have just a better team. Like, not player-wise, but team comp-wise. But it really depends on how people play it out. Like, Kabrakan has so many good targets to really fucking kill. Giannis, Scotty, and Ares should always die to Kabrakan. Like, if he Kabrakan ults any of them, like, that's it. Should be just G's right there. Daquan's gonna slap people. Thana OP. Depends on how Thana plays. Nuclear Eli could just feed his shit. And also depends if Nox hits his shit. Setup wise, believe it or not, this Nox just has to raw hit all of his abilities. Unless Kabrakan stuns and starts mid lane and just stuns everybody, like, Nox is gonna have to work to get her damage off. So, like I said, very skill dependent match. Can both teams pick the same god, like, in quick play? No. That's scrub, bro. Yeah, fuck that shit. That's actually dumb. Incon W. But yeah, now, overall, we'll see. It should be, like, around 2 minutes until the match starts. We're just chilling. And then I'm gonna hop off. Please critique Nox build when the game starts. Sure, Daquan. Anything for you, brother. Anything for you. Why Ares, though? Like, what's he setting up? The thing is, it's Ares is super skill dependent. Ares did just get buffed. But I don't see it really doing anything. If he can... Yeah, there's no way Ares can land his chain on Thana. Thana's just way too fast. Rama might help. But that's it. Everything else is going to be like, alright, what are you really chaining in a team fight? So, unless Director Scar has, like, a vision. You know what I mean? Like, that's not my vision. My vision right now is not Ares. On God. It is really not Ares. This Ares shit is just not gonna work. When was Ares buff last patch? His chains do more damage to the minions, so he actually has a little bit better clear. Or like he can like chain people and clear because he's chaining people. So if you land all three chains, you also clear, you fuck the wave. Alright. Well, do this game, I'll take off my camera. Easy peasy. Starting the game. Lima Beans, Mana, Legendary Leia, Steam Spark. I haven't seen Steam Spark play in a bit. I forgot if he's good or not. He might be shit. And Director Scar. Honestly, Director Scar is going to feed his shit off. There's no way. This is like... The red team's comp is like super anti-Ares. They are anti-Ares like to the max. Everything. Thana fucks Ares. Nox fucks Ares. Rama just fucks. Kabrakan fucks Ares. Wukong fucks Ares. Like there's so many things that have sexual intercourse with Ares. That Director Scar is just gonna go. I'm calling it right now. Director Scar is going 0-10. 0-10. Maybe more. 0-11. 0-12. 0-13. There's so many possibilities of the feed. But our red team is Mr. T-Nasty, Daquan, the Mistborn, Nuclear, Eli, Armstead. So. It's one of those games, huh? Alright, Golden Sash 2. What the fuck? No potion? No, okay, a little bit of potions. 2 mana potions, 1 HP. That's a thing. Kabrakan support starting mid. I love this. The support starting mid, I enjoy immensely. Because you're not... I mean, granted, they would fuck the Scotty Ares lane. But it doesn't matter. Like, they're just... Now, they're gonna control all of this out of the map. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be good. Legendary Leia playing Osiris in the soul lane. Not actually able to do anything. He's just gonna get outpushed here. Doesn't want to take damage, obviously, but... Now they're free to just take his blue. They're gonna take pretty much everything. And there's nothing they should be able to do about it, but... Wait a minute. Okay, they fucked up. Okay. The Kabrakan and Nox went to do speed instead, so instead of collapsing on the speed, at least delaying it, they didn't take full advantage of the 3v4 situation, so that's something. Double chains getting out. Director Scar, proving me wrong. Beating down motherfuckers. But yeah, like, that was a blunder, because now you're taking away from the jungler's farm, right? You didn't contest speed, which was like your only job, which they easily could've. And yeah, that's about it, so... Because Nox Kabrakan has some of the best clear level 1. He just slaps down the wave. So, like, they could have easily just walked up and just be like, yeah, we're just big cocksuckers. But, yeah, okay. I guess it's whatever. So, what could have been more experience than is, like, you know, very averagely level 4. Could have been more. Let's take a look at the Susanna's level. He's level 3. I don't know if he's going to be hitting level 4 anytime soon, but for right now, he's behind. Meanwhile, in the dual lane, looks like they're getting oracles. I like this play. Maximizing farm. They have a lot of farm to actually get. Changing the oracles for extra damage in the mid lane. 3-man splitting. Yeah, Lima Beans is still... Okay, maybe he is farther behind. I don't know. Maybe he is behind. By a large margin. I want to see what Director Scar does here. Does he like camp dual lane? Does he rotate? Because when is the time to rotate? Alright. Double chains. Triple chains. No juking out of Rama, by the way. He just stood in a straight line and literally was like, you know what? Fuck my shit up, family. So, I don't know.
Miss me on that. Like at least wiggle or something. That's a lot of new players' biggest problem. They don't realize that everything in this game is a skill shot, so you don't have to stand there and just get fucked. You can do something about it in this game, which allows for a lot more counterplay than a game like League of Legends or Dota 2 or some shit where like you just have auto lock-on abilities, but three-man gank can't come in dual lane. Thana could be the target, but he just hit 5. The chains are out. One chain should be enough to force hole, and there it is. I respect it. I respect it. He might go back in. No, looks like he's backing off. And that's it. They could still do something. It depends on how this Ares plays it out. Meanwhile, in the soul lane, it looks like Giannis is contesting Ellie's. So nothing crazy kind of happening. Daquan missing. And he's actually not able to get full experience there. So I do like the fact that even though they're at a numbers disadvantage, you know, they still contested buffs. Like this Giannis was like, you know what? I'm not going to let you have everything. Mata doing the things. I respect that shit, boy. Can I switch around the names? Yeah, I forgot about that, to be honest. I forgot. How do I switch? Oh, that's so cool. I'm so happy I can switch.
Excuse me.
Oh, man. All right, should be a lot better now. All right, in the soul lane. I guess just from the early start, Daquan's going to have an advantage. But Legendary Lay is like right there. Not too far behind. And now he's going to lose. Oh, okay. He got his blue buff. He's going to get the wave here on the back side of things. I respect it. What's good about Osiris with Death's Toll, especially with the cleave, the Death's Toll just comes in handy for sustaining yourself through laning phase here. Meanwhile, in the mid lane. Actual big engagement. Kabrakan ult's down, but he's at half. He could pull here. Oh, he's going for the Thana. I don't know if I probably would have went for the Kabrakan, to be honest. And then they're going the Ares here. I like the portal. And he's roasting. Nothing really kind of happening. Disengage from both teams. I really thought he was going to go on the Kabrakan. Like, that would have been clean. Somehow, Daquan just got 2 levels on Legendary Lay. I don't know. Looks like he's lagging. What the? What the fuck? Like, miss me on that. Like, honestly, like that lag might be a big issue for the rest of the laning phase, honestly. Because that was fucking... That was some Latin America shit, like... Mm-mm. Meanwhile, in the dual lane, gank coming out, Armstead catching out Steam Spark, pause coming out. It's probably for Legendary Leia. Never mind, the unpause. BM. Game pause by Lima Beans. Alright, it's probably for Legendary Leia to restart. We'll wait. Actually, can we speed this up because it's a spectator? No, we can't actually speed it up because, wait, no, we can, right? Okay. What the? Okay. We're good. Meanwhile, Oracle's going down to the red team. Uh-oh, they could capitalize. No, never mind. They don't recognize that the Oracles are going down. Or maybe choose to not contest. Legendary Lair probably had to restart because that lag was... Look at this Latin... Ooh, what the fuck? Oh, God. That lag is just fucking nasty. He's skipping everywhere. Like, legitimately, he's just like... His internet connection is just not good. It's not there. It is not there. Which sucks because Legendary Lay is actually a really good fucking Masters player. So this really is going to hurt his chances of winning this game. Both lanes kind of just farming it out. Nothing crazy really happening. The Nox did, by the way, go right into Warlock Sash. Still no boots, which I'm, like, fucking shocked about. I'm shocked that he's getting away with it. That's the only thing, with movement speed being so important. He could go for the 1v1 here. Dog out. I don't know why he backed off. But now, Thana's in the air. We do have a gank going down. It looks like tunnel vision. Oh, actually, never mind. They went on the Ares instead. Ram in the air. His ult just came up. Dirk Discard is the target. 1v3. I respect. Hopefully, the dog can finish. All missing the auto, bro. Oh god. Bro, those missed autos. Like, how the... I don't know. That shit was just ugly. He could at least kept the dog on him, but he called back the dog, like, last second. Like, just kind of a big blunder there. And obviously, Arsuzano was not in position to really follow up or do anything. I mean, it was good rotation out of the red team. It's just, like, bad communication out of the blue team. Director Scar getting caught. I'm telling you, Director Scar is just going to have to feed, really. Like, there's no way. They're just going to keep collapsing on him the second. Like, if his team can't follow up, Director Scar's doomed to a life of feeding. Four-man split at the blue buff for the red team. God bless. God bless. Who don't like that shit? All right, this is actually a really good gank tank attempt. He's got to hit the chain. All right, there it is. I like, you know what? I like the weight there to guarantee hitting three chains so he doesn't get juked. So direct the Scar with great patience and no warning for both teams, really, on the left side of the map. John Obono. Thank you, bro. I appreciate the subscription. Welcome to the church. God bless. Thank you, man. Honestly, I do appreciate it. But yeah, no, great. Great presence of mind of Director Scar to kind of just wait there. Granted, he could have just walked up and chained, but they're actually trying to help him too, bro. All right, I was about to say, if he didn't die, what the fuck? I do like the attempt there. I appreciate the attempt out of the team, but it looks like Steam Spark lagged out. I was like, what the fuck is he doing? But yeah, no, he completely lagged out. I wonder if a pause will come out. I don't know how he missed the Thanos all, honestly. That shit was ugly as fuck. But whatever, right? Nuclear Eli still making it happen for his team. 1-0-1-0-3. Lagging away. Actually, that probably helped him miss the Scythe there. Shasta Legendary Leia's internet. So, the one thing we learned here is that blue team has, like, the most poopy internet I've ever seen. Like, they are on McDonald's Wi-Fi right now because, yeah, Steam Spark's lagging. Legendary Leia, bro, it looks like he's hacking. Like, on God, if I saw this in a game, I'd report him. Just, he's hacking. There's no way. Bro, he's actually, like, he's lagging so bad. Like, that shit is fucking, that's terrible. Like, miss me on that. Like, I would never play even with that kind of fucking internet. It looks like Wukong kind of dashed in there and didn't realize there was three. Kabrak and all, they can actually, yeah, they're just going to kill Director Scar. He's dead as fuck. Like I said, he's just going to feed. There's nothing, this is the anti-Ares comp, if I've ever seen one in my goddamn life. Super anti-Ares. Which, honestly, it was a last pick. I don't know how. Like on God. Director Scar is fucking crazy. Because he saw this comp. He saw this. And was like, yeah, Ares. Like, what? How the fuck? Like, what? I don't know, dude. How the fuck do you see this comp and just be like, yeah, Ares? Like, trust me, this shit bangs, bro. Like, hello? I love this, like, I love this. What the fuck is this shit? Rama, meanwhile, is getting, bro, Rama's dead. This is the second shot, actually. No, but block the stuff, at least. Kabrak could kill right now. Yeah, Kabrak and Armstead just soloing Steam Spark. This Rama almost gets out, meanwhile. Back here, Kabrakan should die. Nice rotation on the blue team. The pop-up's clean. Portal even cleaner. The Kabrakan has beads. I mean, I guess for the Ares, but I don't think that still is necessary. Oh, the meditation's so clean, but don't matter. Nuclear Eli picking up the kill on Lima Beans. And yeah, I don't know, dude. That I still can't believe the Kabrakan had beat. That threw me fucking off. I wasn't paying attention really to his relic choices. Can we get the damage? Sure. Let's take a look at the damage. Player damage wise, Scotty on top because Scotty OP. Mata's second. I don't know. Blue team's doing damage. Even Ares is up there. It's just they're not translating it to anything. I think that's the biggest thing. There's no translation of that to anything. Director Scar going for the gank onto the Rama. Oh my god, he's getting blown up. Crazy damage. No Scotty follow up. And honestly, you know what the biggest blunder there? Scotty didn't trust Director Scar. The Scotty did not trust him. And they do not have any vision or pressure on the map, but they choose to tower dive, and now they have sealed their fate. That's right. Blue team actually get out. No, Director Scar. Steam Spark dies. Director Scar is next. There's the Kabrakan ult. Grabbing two. Oh my, great portal. The Mana trying really hard to carry this team fight. The chains are clean. I respect it. Oh, alright. Yep. Director Scar, good night. Good night. Oh! Oh! Bro! What is actually... Alright, they kill. They kill him. What the fuck? I don't even know, dude. What the fuck was that shit? Alright, gold actually going to the red team. I don't know, dude. That was... I can't even believe that shit. He actually juked it. But he still died anyway. So blue team really not getting any kind of team fight translation going on. Nuclear Eli is legit boning the blue team. And then fucking Legendary Leia can't get off that McDonald's Wi-Fi. He's just stuck on it. So lagging out, dude. Do be careful. I can't believe that shit. That shit, this shit is a fucking clown fiesta. Right now, I feel bad for Lima Beans. I feel like he's really trying to make some decent things happen, but now he's behind. Kabrakan's above him on level at this point. Like this shit. Look, he's three levels down. Oh, I love the jukes. I appreciate the jukes. Bro, what the fuck? Bro, he lag. Whoa, he lag hacked. Did you see that motherfucker warped? Alright, Legendary Leia is hacking. Banned. Caught it on tape. This motherfucker is banned. Yeah. Alright, that chain was wild. It was a little, that was a little bit too much. I respect the read. It's just, yeah, let's calm it down there. Meanwhile, oh, I love the pull here. They're just gonna beads it. Should've went for the Thana, realistically. Alright, it was a close chain. I'll give it to him. I'll give it to him. His passive was up. I do understand his passive was up. But he actually warped. Like, it wouldn't have mattered even if his passive was down. You cock. Alright, snowman. Sub or not, you're still getting roasted. I'm literally melt your shit, bro. Because you're a snowman. Get it? Huh? Alright, that was like a DM level joke. But still. That was a pretty big warp. Alright, bro. Garbage ass Scotty, I'm about to cook you. I don't know. Okay, our Scotty is just going to Titansbane? I don't know. I don't really know what to say. I mean, I would still go Titansbane, just I don't know about that early. Like, miss me on that. But, Director Scar is gonna die here if he tries to contest. Director Scar, don't contest. That chain was just terrible. I don't know why they didn't go for it. They could have just killed him, but Director Scar literally walks away scot free. Let's check out the lagger. Alright, the creeps are here, bro. Bro, what? Bro. The creeps are over there. Bro! Bro! I don't know. What the fuck? Alright, maybe he'll get this one. Alright, he got that wave. Good for him. It's not as bad right now. I don't know. Is Mata actually getting caught out here? Oh my god. Mata way out of- Oh! No way! Mata forced the ult out. That Sunder was dirty. That was the dirtiest Sunder I've seen. That was wild. Lima Bean's getting caught out over here. He's toastied-o'd. No, Susano. Actually, he's in the air. They want him. Will they get him? Oh, yeah, he has no escape. The double ult to death. Direct Describe's getting gangbanked. Oh, Pornhub.com. Right there. That he just got ran train on. Not much he can do. 2 and 5. I will give it. He has 2 kills. And let's take a look at the damage. Play damage wise, Director Scar is up there for his team, but with fucking the that was really fucking close. I thought he was gonna steal it. On God, I really thought he was gonna steal it. But yeah, with Mr. Lag Hacks over here, and this Scotty doing some really questionable things. It's not looking. I don't know. Getting the tower here, I do agree with though. This is a good play. You should be able to actually get out in time, and Rama shouldn't. Dash into that. Now he's a level down because he did rotate, but it was still a good rotation. Overall, I think a win here for Rama, but that will help the blue team out for now, is that tier 1. It's also map control. A lot of people forget the towers are very important for controlling regions of the map. For example, when the tier 1 mids go down, it's a lot more open to go to Gold Fury, you know what I mean, for the enemy team. Yo, remove the earth. Thanks for the 2 months in Rama. Welcome back to the church. God bless. I do appreciate it. Meanwhile, Mr. Lag. He's going to hide. Mark of the Vanguard to hide. I mean, this is pretty... This is like a very standard build. I feel bad because he's like lagging to the tower. And now he's dead. And unless he lags away. He might hack. Hold on. He might warp. He might warp. He might warp. I'm waiting. He might just warp completely out. Bro! He actually is warping. Bro, he juked him by mistake. He didn't mean to. Oh, God. Meanwhile, Director Scar is actually going to kill him on his own. He might. Oh, that was so close. Good chain. Second chain not clean. Meanwhile, in the dual lane. Looks like 1v1 might happen. Nope, pushed out. He could have probably went for the 1v1 there. Scotty could at least force ult, but it really depends. Because like I said, Rama is like the best at dealing with Scotty because your auto attacks go through. But yeah, I can't believe Legendary Leia warped away. Like that's wild. They didn't get any, there was no kill translation. You can tell blue team's having the hardest time getting kills right now. The hardest time. They just can't seem to get anything kind of going. Red team's getting all the kills though. Confirmations. And really, but you know what's the thing? If they get a shutdown on Nuclear Eli, they could have the hardest time winning this. I mean, they can have the easiest time winning this game. They need that shutdown gold. Nothing happened. Big grouping by the Gold Fury, but no, looks like Arthana, the hero, wants to actually back up. Daekon really is trying his little heart out. Been farming very effectively. I haven't talked on him much. I respect the Gladiator Shield pickup here. On ability use, he's able to actually heal, and it's extra physical protection. I respect it. With the Mantle of Discord, yeah, Daekwon's looking to frag out. Meanwhile, yeah, no, McDonald's OP. Not actually able to do anything. You can see Director Scrubs falling very far behind on experience. He's level 12, compared to the enemy support, Kabrakan, who's like level 14 with 4 kills. It's not looking good, bruh. Not looking good. There's the Nox pickup, and it looks like, yep, Director Scar. I don't know how he missed that stun. They might actually just kill Kabrakan. There's the shell pop. There's the roast. And yeah, could have been more follow-up. I don't think the red team was ready for that. I mean, they should be looking for the Ares at this point, because Ares translate into objectives like gold, but there should be a free gold regardless. Depends. Mata might like hit land a snipe or something. We'll see. He's going for it. It's out, but it's a little bit too late. Ooh, there go Thana health. All the Director Scar getting chewed up. Nothing he can do. There's the ping. Like, what are you fucking doing? He's like, I'm lagging, bro. McDonald's. What are you fucking doing? Why are you always late to these rotation McDonald's? I swear on God, McDonald's. But yeah, Nuclear Eli is really, he's tearing shit up, bro. He's been just clean. Like, the Phantom plays 8-0-4, not doing anything too crazy special. He's just following up correctly, following his team up. There's the stun. Love it. Poke damage, back up. Respect it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Next play here would be Portal Demon on respawn. Depends on what red team wants to do. They have pretty much control of this game. And like I said, I can't see with the lag coming out of blue team and overall them just not playing their comp correctly, I can't see them coming back. Like, I cannot. And like, not only that, it's just like, they do have Scotty, but it's just, I don't see it, bro. I don't see it, bro. Depends on, like, maybe Scotty pops off. He is the same level as Ramo. He has to go for 1v1s more. Daquan does fall off in ability damage, but he's going to be hitting hard. He's level 20. He's getting close to full build. I mean, really, like, let's see. Has he backed yet? Golden hand. Yeah, he has backed. He doesn't have that much gold. But still, like, he really is just going to be a tanky fucking mess. Storm Incarnate, thank you so much for the Twitch Prime subscribe. I do appreciate it. Welcome back to the church. Oh, actually, welcome to the church. I do appreciate it, bro. Director Scar might get caught out here. He's still level 12, dude. When you have a level 20 against a level 12, he's just going to get evaporated into a team fight. Like, Director Scar better, like, never push up. There's no way he can initiate. So let's talk about blue team's initiation. Really, it's just all up to Osiris to kind of waddle in there. He misses the chain. Once you miss the chain, that's it. There's the Wukong ult. There's the Thanos ult. Initiation-wise, out of red team, they have way superior initiation. Depends, though. He can't solo dive this, so just going to back off. And I respect this. They're like, you know what? We don't have our Rama. Let's get the split push going, baby. Get those towers. Get those objectives, because objectives win the game. But, yeah, everyone's kind of going back to their lanes. And you know what's crazy? They can choose to team fight, or they could choose to just do this, split push pressure. Because red team, they are far enough ahead to do whatever the fuck they want. Realistically, I would like to see a little bit more pressure towards, like, Portal Demon, but I don't know. It's their shot call, really. Oh, that portal was nasty. That portal was good. I like the fadeaway, too. He realized that he was getting approached on. Most Yanises probably would have committed there, and Kabrakan could have ulted. So, Mana trying to get maximized poke damage, but minimize damage taken. God bless. Meanwhile, the collapse on the Osiris. There's the silence. Might actually, I don't know what Kabrakan's doing. Looks like he's chilling. I don't know. He like looked. Could have went for a stun there. I'm not too sure exactly what's going on. There it is. I love it. The wall in. Meanwhile, Wukong actually forced the ult early. There's the chains. I think only gets. Oh, that's an interesting interaction. Yanis ulted through, and he pulled him through the Yanis portal. Then in the air though. I wonder who he lands on. There's nothing. There's not like a hard engage going on here. Meanwhile, in the mid lane. Okay. I respect it, but he misses. Misses. Sanctuary. Beads. Yanis is out. Dude, fight still going on. I can't even believe this shit. Rama poked out the half. Thana should be the target, but he's way too quick. But Susano's in. He's in that ass. He really needs to kill. Scotty picks up the kill. That's a great kill. Especially to go on Scotty. Blue team really trying to bring it back. Rama forced to back away. There's the stun. Legendary Lair. Lagging into that kill. I can't even believe it. Daquan's in there. He doesn't have his ult though. So if he takes too much damage, he doesn't have an escape. There it is. And blue team now are looking to push into an objective, which should be Portal Demon. Yeah, I respect the call here. What I've been calling the whole time, the blue team is like, you know what? We'll listen to you, ally. Don't worry, bro. We got you, bro. No way Daquan should be able to contest this. He's not even there. And yeah, blue team now. They're looking clean. They are looking clean here. Mata being top damage to the blue team is doing the things. I can't even believe that. And that's not only mentioned, I mentioned a shutdown. Crazy shutdown on the Thana. That's actually huge. They all come back. And realistically, what the blue team should do is position and ward around the Gold Fury. They want to push out. Realistically, in an objective-based fight, they either want to focus on the soul lane and just fully commit onto there, or position around the Gold Fury. You want to get wards, right? forward wards to see when they're coming, and you want to push this lane out for pressure. But it looks like they're taking the other option, which is fully commit onto the soul lane, no matter what. It, you know, they could have done gold, they could have done anything else, but yeah. Yanis ult, maybe a little bit too prematurely. I can't imagine. Yeah, I think that was like a panic Yanis ult, so that's down. Now, I don't know how Director Scar is not getting eaten alive, but the tankier he's getting, the harder it is for him to be the focus target. So him getting out of early and mid game with 6 deaths, honestly, that's an achievement. God bless Director Scar. Good shit, brother man. By the way, thank you so much, King Lu. I appreciate the subscription. You are the man. Yeah, all my subs do is throw in meme. Director Scar being the only one on this tier 1. He could have got focused there, but depends on how hard they want to commit. The Nox damage, able to get Osiris to half, so that's going to be big for the next coming team fight. But I can't see the red team being able to push under a tier 1 tower. Depends. Like I said, blue team don't really have initiation with Osiris back, and they could take the 4v5 fight here. Depends on if Osiris has his teleport relic up, which he does. He does. Okay, he does. Just in case the fight breaks out. There's the Gold Fury being started up. Now, here's the blue team. This is tricky. They gotta, like, initiate properly. Daquan, he's getting a little bit of damage. That's a Kabrakan, and yep, there it is. Kabrakan ult, Steam Spark immediately erased. He has no escape out of that shit. Now, 4v5 ADC down. Thana's in. Not able to get anything. Yanis ult, not really able to connect to anything. And Thana is being the focus, but he's way too quick. Yeah, he's not able to actually do anything. Kabrakan, no mana. Red team actually forced to back up. Meanwhile, Mato might actually be able to get some split push. No, backing. Fight still rages on. Osiris, great. Actually, 2-man ult. Stopping any kind of healing. I don't know if he's going to be able to catch this Thana. But, yeah, the red team, even though they won that fight, they did take a lot of damage. Susano's being very tricky, I will say. This Susano, he's doing things. And yeah, red team actually, even though they clearly won that fight, not able to make anything happen. Like, they can't do Gold Fury. And being 5k down, the blue teams, they're holding up. Bro, if that chain hit, forget about it. But it looks like this knock, he's caught. He's caught. He's caught way too much damage. He's down. Lima Bean's credited with the kill. And this is what I mean. Look at Nox's damage. Lowest on the team, right next to Rama in terms of player damage. So really, when you're a Nox player, you really gotta step up. But also at the same time, they don't have any setup for Nox in these team fights. Besides Kabrakan, which it doesn't look like Kabrakan's goal is setup. It looks like Kabrakan's goal is catching, which in my opinion is better than setting up for Nox. Like, being able to catch the Scotty netted them a kill last team fight, right? But like the Nox, you know, he has to rely on his team to kind of set him up, and it's really hard in these team fights because of player movement speed and all that shit. So it's up to the Nox player in terms of skill to keep up in terms of damage. And yeah, that's it. Oh, there's a free Barracuda email. Why even sub? All of Barracuda subs should just unsubscribe right now. Give me the subscribe. Come on, bro. Just give it right to your boy. Give it to me, man. Blue team really have a good chance coming back into this, honestly. They could very easily win, only being 5k down, but they're in a mid to late game, really towards a late game scenario. I want to see more damage coming out of this Rama. I feel like he's been getting fucked. He is double crit, Wind Demon into Deathringer, but no penetration besides Ikval, so. Eh. I don't know how I feel about that build. Because you really need to take down this Ares and Osiris, and they're not being taken down. It's not like they're fully squishy, and you're not really 1v1ing the sky, so what are you doing? Oh, Ares actually getting some good chains. There's the roast onto Wukong, and already, just like that, half health, hitting all three chains, looking for Giannis poke. I appreciate Director Scar's ballsiness. He is very aggressive, even being 2-6. There's the chain, misses the second one. A little bit gun-ho there. Oh, they could easily get initiated on. Blue team here needs to be careful. Kabrakan looking for something. The slapdown's happening, though. Osiris really, he's doing the things. Wukong at half. Could ult, but that would be a premature. Just going to back, which I respect. He does have no teleport relic. That is something to keep in mind. So he has to actually manually walk back. So two people down. Honestly, the blue team should look for something. But how can they even engage into this? Like you have to rely on like Giannis portal or something. But this is an easy way to force an engagement. Start the goal from me. So I respect and I appreciate that. And it looks like they should get this free, actually. They should fully commit, and there it is. Blue team get the gold fury. There's the portal. Three-man all. Direct to Scar actually looking to do stuff. Double pull in. Oh my god, even Thana gets knocked up. There's beads. Direct to Scar pretty low. If Thana goes up in the air, there's the meta. I do appreciate Lemon Bean's credit with the kill. Nuclear Eli down. And red team is actually, they're throwing this game. Nox, not able to hit. Like I said, you gotta hit those abilities. And now, oh my god, the double pull, but Kabrakan's like, you know what, bro? We're just gonna frag your shit. They turn around, and it looks like the focus is Susano. But red team, they might actually be getting double baited. Looks like the pull is in. Oh my god, Nox getting pulled in, and oh, he misses the dash. There's a sanctuary, but I think our McDonald's Wi-Fi Osiris is not able to actually do anything off that. Fight still going on. Scotty ult back up. Armstead going down. Wukong's the next target. I can't even believe this guy. That's murder. Nox getting out 1 HP. I would fucking... Missing the dash there was crucial. It was even a late sanctuary, so... Bro, and I can't believe, just like that, blue team actually... today is comeback day. And blue team, the biggest thing is they're focusing on objectives. At this point, Director Scar is way too tanky to get focused down and not effectively get counter-engaged on, right? So in terms of initiation, counter-engagement is blue team's success. And Director Scar is doing a really good job of baiting. And he's doing a really good job of chasing people. Even looking at the player damage side, like I said, he's being effective force in these team fights. With even with 12k damage, that's still a lot for support to do. Blue team actually just rushed down the Fire Giant. I respect that. And Director Scar is in, looking, is, I don't know, slapping people around. And I wasn't even paying attention. And blue team, they literally just under their nose take Fire Giant, and now blue team are in a position to push down and win this game. All tier 2's up for the red team, so realistically, they, here's the play. Blue team have to now push, they're gonna push mid lane. If they get a pick or two, that's a Phoenix. If they don't get a pick, they get the rest of the tier 2's. So that's the play, really. It depends on how they decide to do this, but it should be a free tier 2 if they decide to just do that. But obviously you want to get some frags in there. Director Scar getting way too low. I don't know if meditation's up from the last time they engage. They could very easily get blown up. There's the initiation. There it is. Rama in the air, but Director Scar's credit with the kill. Nice. Meditation just came up. Whoa, Kabrakan missing that all. It's huge. Red team, there's no way they're going to be able to actually win this team fight now. The pull in, though. Thana no beads, and he's dead. Wukong ult for the healing and also to get out of the Ares ult. And now, like I said, because they got one to two picks, blue team definitely should be able to push into the Phoenix. There's no reason they can't. And there's the shell pop. I respect it. Portal down, zoning. The slap down. Now that you back up, push right. That is where all the creeps are at. But it looks like they're going left. All right. So blue team is also dumb. But it's okay. They should be able to at least tank the tower. Realistically, if they got the creeps, they could have pushed right all the way to Phoenix. But it depends on how they want to play this. Because like I said, there's a full wave here. So if they are going to tank the Phoenix, I don't know. I mean, there are people down for the red team. Two, to be exact, but... Yeah, okay, they're just fully committing here. Now, this is ballsy. They could still lose this altar coming up. Kabrakan, depends on how he plays this out. We need a big boy Kabrakan ult, but yeah, blue team just tank the Phoenix and take it. Now, realistically, with this gold, they should back, push right, and look for another Phoenix attempt while they still have Fire Giant. Fire Giant's still going to be on them for a long, long time, and that looks like the play. Grab their buffs back. Bye. Which I agree with, and now blue team have a crazy fucking lead. I can't even believe this fucking game. Like, I don't know fucking now, dude. That shit is wild to me. Yo, Mace Guy, Numbers, thank you so much for the Twitch Prime subscribe. Glad you enjoyed the stream. Welcome to the motherfucking church. I do appreciate it. By the way, all new subscribers, make sure you go to Discord. Sync up to my sub Discord. I go in there and meme and post pictures. Yep. There it is. This is the last game, by the way, so whoever wins this. I'll do the MVP vote, and then I'll call the stream. But I'm glad that you guys are enjoying the stream. Actually, a lot of viewers today. I'm very happy. I'm a happy boy. But yeah, here's the play. Fire Giant still on them for a little bit. I don't know how long exactly. but yeah, blue team should be able to at least get this tier 2. If not, push a Phoenix, and it looks like the ping is for the Phoenix. They want it. They're going for it. I respect this call. They are super far ahead. Even if they throw here, red team can't even get the Fire Giant or counter push. Like, they'll be lucky to get tier 1 mid. So, yeah, with the Fire Creeps pouring. Direct Scrub being the focus immediately. Completely caught out. Great Nox bullshit. There's no way. Meditation pops. He's dead regardless. The Thena ult missed, though. Need the healing. Not going to be able to actually get Daquan. Is the focus. Forced the ult immediately. He was able to heal up in the ult form. He's in, though. He gets knocked up. Not too sure what he was going for. Llama Beans gets the kill. 1v1 goes down. Rama versus Scotty. Who gets it? Great Sanctuary. And the dog is literally going to solo him. Mistborn going for the craziest 1v1. Like, in the back line of the team fight. Hello. Not too sure what he was going for there. I mean, I respect it. I just don't know if that was the vision. You know what I'm saying? But Lyman Beans caught out Nox Root, which I do appreciate. Oh my god, Mata able to port out 1 HP. And Armstead is going down. Steam Spark really. He's in. He's making the shit happen. It's a very rough landing phase, but he's doing the things right now. And just like that, all three Phoenix is down. Fire Giant coming up. Blue team is gonna get the Fire Giant. They should. There should be no reason why they can't just run there and end. Man, that last team fight, I think the biggest blunder was Mistborn just rolling into the back line. Well, one, you never want me on the Scotty mid to late game. There's no point. You just get literally, the dog soloed him. Like, honestly, the dog. So, like, the Scotty didn't actually have to do anything. You know what would actually be a good nerf? When you Sanctuary, Caldera stops attacking. I think that's how it should be. Because, you know, everyone else when the Sanctuary can attack or do damage, why do you? Unless it's like a damage over time kind of thing. But Caldeer doesn't count as a damage over time. That's kind of silly. Thana actually might get caught out. There's the Osiris ult. Forcing the Thana ult. Don't know. Alright, Mata. Let's calm it down. I know you're feeling yourself. You know, you guys are actually winning. You've been patient. You earned it, but Giannis ult being down might be big for the next team fight. Ooh, popping the pop something. That's what it looked like. Crazy damage coming out of Mata. Mid Phoenix should very easily go down. And now left Phoenix on respawn. The Ares pull. There's the initiation forcing the bees on Rama. They should realistically get left Phoenix and then push into the Titan. And that might be the play. Even if red team initiate on them. Unless they get a really big pick and one shot someone. I can't see how the red team would lose this. Great portal forcing another pair of beads. There's Kabrakians looking. Giannis is the target. But I don't know if that should be the target. Daquan forced the ult immediately. And old Rama, double snipe. I love the portal on the ground, though. Able to actually avoid. Wukong is in. Phoenix dive going down. But, yeah, no kills really happening. The Direct Scar a little bit low, though. Thana ult should be coming up. Direct Scar can get out. Armstead catches him in. There's Thana ult completely missing. That was no bueno. But Legendary Leia does go down. Big throw coming out. Steam Spark's going down. I mean, is this the... Is this a throw? Can they end? It depends. Mata has to be a big boy, and he might actually go for it. Mata, on God, he might actually go for it. Oh my God, half health. Immediately. I wonder if Mata has his ult. Should go for the snipe, on God. That would be fucking hype as shit, but doesn't look like he doesn't have ult. So, just backing up. I appreciate him stealing speed. Good call. Granted, he should get red. I don't think he should have picked it up, but whatever. We got a zoom. You know what? All this downtime, Mata should just go for like a one-shot on a snipe on someone. I don't know if he would. I don't know if he has the balls, the cojones, to go for the one-shot. Realistically, blue team can drop ship, which is all five people into the Titan and just end it, but we'll see. He might go for a pick here. He's got to be careful. Kabrakan could just crack in his shit. He could very easily portal to the Rama and kill him. Depends. I know a lot of beads are down. Almost. Not that it would have killed, but that would have been crazy poke. Now with the blue team up, they can choose either to just go for the right Phoenix. Fire Giant's down for a bit, so realistically they should look to make some sort of attempt to do something. Red team's left Phoenix just came in up, right Phoenix for me. If Mata's a man, he'll go for the ult one shot. If Mata's the man, it depends. He needs vision. I know that for a fact. He's just looking for poke, which I also appreciate. A lot of pressure. You can't really go into the jungle alone or else Sionis fucking taps you for half your health, which is oh so fun to deal with. Who doesn't like that shit? Alright, so now Giannis, we need to see the Giannis one shot. It needs to be on one of the carries. Can't throw, direct discard, can't get caught out. Nox can't get anything going, but there it is. Some decent poke on Legendary Leia, nothing crazy. Giannis snipe, very bad. Completely obvious. Nox ult does hit, Wukong in the air. Meanwhile, the front line, oh, not able to actually get Heavenly Agility popped. Sprint is down. Actually, he's able to get Mistborn. Mistborn down Thana all the way in the back by himself. Oh, does he go for it? Is he really? Oh! Steam Spark. That shit was fucking terrible. And now, the red team, I don't know, like, they're holding. I mean, Phoenixes are coming up. They really need this Phoenix to stand. It's not. It's down. But mid and left are coming up. So, that's good. Yeah. I don't know. Oh, what the? I don't know, dude. They should just ult the Titan, right? Ugh. In my personal opinion, as a old school professional player, they should just really just go and end the fucking game. But that's just me. Maybe I'm the crazy one. What is Direct Discard's build? Ooh. What the fuck? That's the Direct Discard going for the no HP build. Direct Discard is like, you know what? I don't want ult. I don't want ult. Alright, so Susano late game with a 3k potion. He could, maybe not the Kabrakin, but like if Rama comes in, he could Draco the Rama. Like, on God. This Rama's gotta be very careful. They have so many targets that can one-shot him, but he is late game full build. I don't know how I feel about the Kin size. I feel like this should be an executioner, but overall he should be doing a lot of damage. Let's take a look at the player damage chart. We have a little bit of time here. Fire Giant being started up. I don't know. They can't decide on what they want to do. Fire Giant and Poor Lima at the same time. Mata top damage, as expected. Giannis late game overpowered. Somehow Osiris is late game. I gotta copy this build down. Odyssey Bow. That is his only item, and Frostbound Hammer actually. That is the only two items he have, and he's at 3k, so 26k for the Scotty. So blue team has some damage dealers, but our Wukong friend Daquan, he's up there too. A lot of damage coming out from both teams. A lot of damage. There's the Giannis ult missing completely. Absolutely. That's a waste. I don't know. He's in. There's the Nox ult. Who's it hitting? Oh my god. Our Giannis is low. Daquan forced the ult immediately. I like this. Poke. Back the fuck up. Poke back up. Oh, Thana ult down. That's big too. Osiris. Looks like he's getting targeted. I don't know what that Susan ult though. That Susan ult was ugly as fuck. I think he thought they were committing more, but that's not necessarily the case. They should just kill the Titan, really. Titan's sitting there is like, just fuck me up, fam. Just kill the Titan. But Kabrakin's in. Scotty's getting targeted. Kill the Titan. Just focus the Titan. Come on, guys. Just hit the Titan. Come on. Alright. I was gonna say, the Giannis luckily saved the day, but yeah, that was like, I want to say 15 minutes way too long. 15 minutes way too long. But yeah, let me do the straw poll. Who the fuck? Who is MVP? Who was MVP? Was it Llama, Bienz, Susano, Legendary, Leia, Osiris with McDonald's Wi-Fi? Who the fuck was this Scotty? Steam Spark. Scotty. Director Scar Ares. Mata Giannis. I have in my head who I think MVP is, but let's see what chat has to say. Feel free to vote so we can give these guys gems. Let's see the results. Yeah, it looks like, I don't know. Oh my god. Legendary Leia. He's really gonna get gems. You guys are troll as fuck. This is... I mean, granted, Legendary Leia did play spectacular. Like, even with the leg. That shit was good. That shit was clean. But Legendary Leia looks like he's winning. I mean, I can't imagine in, like, another minute or so anyone beats him. So, Legendary Leia, congratulations on the gems. Just a clean victory. So, Mini Flav and Legendary Leia, congrats, guys. You guys are the gem winners for today. Tomorrow, purely subs only.